Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is part two of the 1,000 subscribers celebration, and it's the continuation of part two, and it's the answers to my Q&A video. I've done a lot of Q&A videos on my channel, and I just want to thank everyone who asked a question. It means a lot, and I'll probably have more in the future, and I got enough questions that I can answer them all. If I got like 40 questions, I couldn't answer them all, so I'm just gonna dive right in and start answering the questions. Okay, question number one is from Batboy Manny, and he has three questions. And the first question is, what is your favorite Wizard of Oz item you have? And I have quite a few, but I just decided to go with these two. The first one is this Wicked Witch statue that I have. I love Margaret Hamilton's Wicked Witch, so... unfortunately, when I first got her, I got her off eBay, she came broken. But I was able to glue her, and, you know, she's very delicate, but... at least I didn't have to throw her away. I wanted this for a long time. I just love all the details on her. And I just love the Wicked Witch. And then, this ornament I got last year at the Hallmark store. I saw it and I pretty much had to have it. It is a talking Wicked Witch ornament. And if we... I would press...
You and your dog! You've been more trouble to me than you're worth one way or another. But it'll soon be over now!
Unfortunately, it's not Margaret Hamilton's voice, but it's still a pretty menacing voice. I just love the face sculpt, and I just love this so much. I also do love the Pop Funko Wicked Witch, which I do also have. His second question is, can you do a room tour collection, card collection, book, comic book collection, just some video suggestions. Well, after this video, most likely on Saturday, I am doing a room tour. It's going to be the final part to my 1,000 subscriber celebration, but I will definitely keep the card and comic book collections in mind. I don't really like doing collection videos in a row. I like separating them off on my channel, so... And Batboy's Manny's final question. Now, I got two of this question, so I'm only going to answer it one time, and when I get to the other question, I will give the other person a shout-out. Have you seen the new American Horror Story episode? If so, what did you think of it? I did, and I just got done watching the second episode. The first episode, to be honest, I wasn't impressed. Since Freak Show, I just haven't been impressed. I love the first three seasons, Murder House, Asylum, and Cabin. And I did like Freak Show, and I still liked watching it. It wasn't the best for me. And Hotel, it's getting better. In the second episode, it was better than the first episode. But there is a huge, huge space missing. And that is Jessica Lange. I know she wanted to take a break this year. And she should be making a cameo as Constance, her character in the first season. But I miss her. I'm a huge Jessica Lange fan. I love her in American Horror Story. And I miss her, presence there in almost every episode. She was not too big in the first first season, but then in season 2 and season 3 she was more of a bigger character, but I just love her in season 4 as well. And these are the Funko Pops of her, the Fiona Good and Elsa Mars. And I really hope in season 6, if they do make a season 6, she comes back as a main character, because the show's just not the same without her. Lady Gaga is okay. She is pretty menacing, but No one can outdo Jessica Lange's characters. So, thank you, Batboy Manny, for asking those questions. And we'll go to the other next question. The next question comes now, I'm probably going to butcher this name, and I'm so sorry, comes from God of Rhodes. I'm not sure how to say that, but it's spelled God O-F Rhodes. So, sorry if I messed up that name, but his question is, if you could own any prop from Star Wars, what would it be? Well, I would want to, like, own a lot from Star Wars, but I have two. First is the Queen Amidala, or Queen Throne in the prequel trilogy. I know Padme is not the only one that sits on it, but I would love to own that in, like, my living room and just watch movies and TV on that. I think that would be a blast. And then my next one is the actual black pistol blaster Padme uses. I would love to have that. So, of course, I would love to own a lot more props, but that is just two that I would really like to own, especially that throne. So, thank you for the question, and thank you. Okay, we are on question number three, I think, and that the next question comes from The Angry Squad, and he has three questions. Number one, what is your favorite Walking Dead episode? That's always been hard for me, to be honest, just because there's so many great episodes, especially in season one and two, because those are my most favorite seasons. I'm gonna have to go with the season two finale. I just always love the intense scene when everybody's like split up and fighting all the walkers on the barn, and you know, Rick just killed Shane, and Lori is split up from Rick and Carl, and Herschel is split up from Beth and Maggie, and Beth and Glenn and Maggie is split up from the rest of them, and they're just all driving on the farm, and Andrea gets left behind, and I just love that intense scene. And then when they all come back and meet up on the highway, I thought it was a good end to season two. The only thing I wish is Andrea can't get left behind. I know that, you know, that had to happen to meet Majone and to add part of the story, but I just love that. And then the scene when Rick tells Lori that about Shane, and then that Carl used the gun. I do just want to note that is why Lori did get mad. Lori did not get mad because he killed Shane. She got mad because her son that was just shot recently used a gun. So, just wanted to throw that out there. I know a lot of people like to think she got mad because Shane was dead. No, that wasn't the case. But that is probably my number one favorite episode. I just love season two. I know they were on, like, the farm the whole time, but I just love season two. I also love The Grove in season four, the Carol episode, and that's such a sad episode, but such a great one, too. The next question, are you going to get any of the older Walking Dead figures? Well, I want at least one of every character. I do have, like, two Ricks and two Carls, which is fine. If I have one of every character, I'll be fine. But, like, I didn't hunt for Rick or Carl right here. I found them in stores and said, why not? I would like to add them to my collection. Unfortunately, Series 1 is very expensive. So, I don't know if I'll ever get those. But I would like to get every figure. If not almost every figure. I know I need more walkers. And his final question is, who is your least favorite main Star Wars character? And that would be Mr. Kenobi right here. I know a lot of people are going to disagree with me, and that's totally fine. I didn't mind Obi-Wan in episode 1. I actually kind of liked him in episode 1. In episode 2, he was okay, but episode 3 was when what he did. And let me just explain that for to you. He was fine in episode 3 until he went to, when Anakin went to Mustafar and he went to Padme and Anakin's apartment. And he asked Padme where Anakin was, and she obviously didn't know, but she didn't want to tell Obi-Wan because she knew that he would go kill him. If he never went there, she wouldn't be worried. So one, he worried her about Anakin and made her think that he was going to go kill him. Two, it made her go to Mustafar herself. If he never told her or asked about Anakin, she would have stayed home. And three is when he appeared on the ship behind her, making Anakin think that Padme brought Obi-Wan there to kill him, which was not the case, and then which caused Padme to get force choked. So that's pretty much the reason I don't like Obi-Wan, pretty much because he used Padme. And I know he couldn't have done much by just, when he was getting force choked, maybe he could have just, ran and charged Anakin. I just don't like what Obi-Wan did, and he's my least favorite of the main characters. So, thank you, the Angry Squad, for the questions, and we will move on to the next question. Our next question comes from JCCG. This may be impossible, but here it goes. Out of everything that you have collected on all the desire characters, which single item would you say is your most favorite of all? Well, that is a hard question. It's not impossible, but it is pretty tough. Because I have many favorite things. I don't buy it if it's not my, at least in my favorite thing. List of favorite thing. But I'm gonna pick, and I don't know if this counts because it's not official, but I do have an official item I will show you, too. My custom Laurie Grimes figure from The Walking Dead. I have three customs, one I made, but two customs I bought off different people from different groups. And this is my Laurie custom. I'm not gonna say who made it just for safety issues, but when I first got her, I fell in love with it, and the person who made this did a fantastic job. I don't know how, but he got the face pretty down right, the hair, the outfit, and this is one of my favorite outfits of her. And I just was really pleased, because, and just in case, we don't get a Laurie figure from McFarlane, I do want to say a fan recently asked him at a convention about a Laurie figure. Oops, and there she goes. And he did say she was a possibility, and she is on the list. Anyone, I guess, could be on the list, but that is huge news for me and for other people who want a Laurie figure. And I was able to give her the gun that came with Carol because she does use that one too. And I think that's where Carol got it from after Laurie passed away. So if that doesn't count, because I know this is kind of a one thing in the whole world, and if the person who makes them makes another one, I'm going to show you just an official figure. And that has to be this one. My Queen Amidala celebration figure. I'm just going to move Laurie out of the way for a minute. Like I said, I have a lot of favorite things, especially favorite official things. But I just wanted to keep it simple. Let me get her Globe of Peace in. And I just, you guys know I love this Queen Amidala. It's my favorite Queen Amidala figure. And I think the detail on her is amazing. I think without even using any soft goods, the texturing, the cloak is pretty nice, neat detailed. Of course, the only thing missing is the white makeup, but that's okay. But this probably would be one of my favorite things ever, just because I remember wanting this figure so, so bad. So that is my favorite thing official, but At the end of the day, if I had to pick a favorite thing, I'd probably go back with Lori just because it's a one of a kind. And I just love looking at her, and she's amazing. I'm glad to have her in my collection. So thank you, GCCG, for that question. Now, before I go on to the other question, I did get another question asking if I saw the new American Horror Story episode. I did, and this, I don't know if you guys are the same people. Let me know, Manny D. I don't know if Batboy Manny and Manny D are the same people, but if not, I'm sorry, I did, and I explained it earlier, so... but thank you for asking that question. The next question comes from DarthPhoenix619. Tony, how are you? His question is, top three favorite Padme outfits. That is another hard one, because all her outfits are stunning and beautiful. But I did pick three, and since there is no figure of this outfit made yet, unfortunately, I hope one day they do decide to. I'm going to go with number one being the picnic outfit. I think it's a really pretty outfit. She looks gorgeous in it. Love the hair. Kind of like reminiscent of Leia's head buns. The hairstyle is beautiful. And the gown itself is really pretty too. So yeah, I always love this outfit. I hope Hasbro makes a figure one day of that. I've heard in that outfit. Number two, I'm gonna go with, the Lars Homestead outfit. I think it is really pretty, and pretty detailed, and I'm talking about the real life one, not the figure, but, she looks really nicely done in it. And number three, I'm gonna go with the battle dress one. I really... like, it's pretty simple, but it's, you know, it's regal, too. You know, like I said, it's simple, not much to it, but I really liked how she looks in it. So, there. Your question is, Tony, thank you for asking. And, the next question comes from the... TWD, The Walking Dead Figures, and more. Do you plan on picking up Series 8 of The Walking Dead Figures? Congrats. Well, first of all, thank you. And I do. I really want Dale, Morgan, and Eugene, all the characters I don't have. I do want the Rick, too, but I can wait on the Rick since I already have two Ricks. But unfortunately, I probably won't be getting them anytime soon. Because every time new figures come out, I'm broke. And I'm unemployed right now, so unfortunately, my lack of spending money and adding more to my collection, is stopped at the moment. I can't really, just like before when I was able to afford to buy things, I really do want them, but usually when they appear in stores, that's when I usually get them. You're more welcome to send them. I do have a fan mail address if you want, and I would review them. I'm kidding, but if you would like to, it's there. But yeah, I do plan to adding them to my collection. As I said, I want one of every character. So yeah. So thank you, The Walking Dead Figures and More, for asking that question. And we'll be back with the next question. We have two more questions after this. Next question comes from one of my favorite YouTubers ever, and that is Victoria's Cantina. Great channel. Hi, Victoria. Her question is, have you been to any of the Disney parks? If so, what's your favorite attraction? If not, what park would you like to visit? The first question is, yes, I have been. I've been to Disneyland. I'm from California. I'm living in New York right now. Just personal reasons I don't want to get into. I used to live in Orange County. That's kind of an hour outside of Los Angeles. So I used to live about 15-20 minutes away from Disneyland, but it's not like I would go often, but I have been there many times. And my favorite attraction is, of course, the Snow White ride. I just love how it is when you ride and you see all the scenes, and that just, Snow White, the Disney Snow White, is very special to me. And when I go on that ride, I just love it. When I see anything around Disneyland Snow White, I just get very excited. I would love to go to Walt Disney World someday, but I at least I've been to Disneyland, and yes, my favorite ride is Snow White. I think it's called Snow White Scary Adventures, and I love at the top of it is the Evil Queen looking out the window. I could stand there for hours and just watch her. I love that. Since the Evil Queen is my favorite Disney character. So, thank you, Victoria, for that question. And we will move on to the next and final question. We'll be back. Okay, our next and final questions come from MG Villain, MP478. Manny, hi, how are you doing? And he has three questions, it looks like. His first question is, I want to know if you read comics. And, I do. I don't read them often, but I do have quite a few. When I lived in California, there was a comic shop that I would go to often. They mostly sold comics. They had a few figures here and there, but mostly comics. And I would, and they were like, very cheap, like $1.25 to $5. I would always go there, and they had them, and they had them in these slip covers, as you can see, and you can buy them, and you weren't really allowed to look at them. And I actually asked I would always ask the guy if he could open it and I could see what the pictures looked like. And, most of the comics I have are Batman. I'm a huge Batman fan. And these three comics are some of my favorite, and I have read them before. There's a lot of comics I bought just because of the covers looked. So I'm not gonna even go into explaining the plots of these. I will say this one is pretty sad because it's like, what if Bruce Wayne's parents has lived? And that's what I remember. I think that's what the plot is. But the other two are just as good. And I do have a lot of comics if I ever get bored to read. Because I, like I said, would just get them because the cover looked nice. And I haven't read them yet. So I do read comics. Like I said, not often. But I do, and most of my comics are Batman. I do have some Spider-Man, because Spider-Man is my favorite Marvel hero. And and I think I have a few other ones here and there. So, I will be back with the next question. Oops. And Manny's final question is, if I collect Disney movies, and what is my favorite Disney movie? First, I do collect Disney movies. It's not something I get all the Disney movies. I would like to get all the classic Disney movies, but I do collect Disney movies. I don't have them all, but here are a few. I have Snow White, Cinderella, Sleeping Beauty, Little Mermaid, and Alice in Wonderland. I also do have more. These are just the ones I pulled out. I love Disney, especially these classics. These are all classics right here. And they will never die. My favorite Disney movie, well, if you haven't been watching my channel, or it is definitely Snow White. I love all the classic Disney movies, but Snow White just really stuck with me, and I just have loved it my whole life. Like I said, I love Cinderella, Sleeping Beauty, Little Mermaid, Alice in Wonderland, Lion King. I love them all, but Snow White is my number one favorite. I love the story, the characters, the music, and for Walt Disney's first movie, it is a masterpiece. Some might disagree, but that is my opinion, and I just, I just adore it. So thank you, Manny, for those questions. And I actually have one more question, and I will be back with the final question. And the last question comes to us from the comic figure blog, Andrew, I believe. And his question is, and I almost missed this, thank goodness I didn't. His question is, what are my thoughts on the upcoming Star Wars trilogy and all the spin-offs? Well, let's start with the Star Wars trilogy. To be honest, at first, when episode 7 was announced, I was not excited at all. You know, don't get me wrong, I'm a huge Star Wars fan and have been for a very long time, but I just thought we didn't need any more movies. And when you think about it, 9 movies are a lot. I mean, some franchises have that many, like Halloween almost has that many, I think, Friday the 13th, and Lord of the Rings, but a lot of others. So, but that's all I could think when they first were announced, like, really? Another, more Star Wars movies, and you know, I thought episode 6, Return of the Jedi, was a perfect ending. But as I get, as we get closer and closer, I get more excited and curious about the characters, especially Rey, as you can see. And you're probably wondering why I gave her figure the blaster. It's because of her staff broke, and I wanted her to hold something. We don't know if she uses a stormtrooper blaster, but that's what my Rey's holding for now. Anyways, but, I just hope Abrams, or J.J. Abrams, does not mess it up, which I don't think he will, because he's a huge Star Wars fan, and I just hope it's not messed up, and I hope, my biggest hope is, I hope it is connected to the prequel still, because it seems like, especially with all the merchandise, the prequels aren't getting much attention. I hope they stay connected to all the movies, you know, which I hope so, and I'm excited to find out who all the new characters are, yeah, the spin-offs, I haven't really, to be honest, thought about them that much. I know there was a Han Solo movie rumored. I don't know if that came. I really honestly don't know what spin-offs are coming out. I know a Han Solo movie was, rumored. I don't know if that's true. Also, a Boba Fett one and a Yoda one. I don't know if any of those true. So if you know, if they are, just let me know. And just let me know what the other spin-offs are. Obviously, I'm not that much excited for them if I'm not thinking about them. But I'll at least see the new 3 in theaters. I know I will. I'm not sure about the spin-offs, but when we talk about spin-offs, I think it's a little too much for Star Wars, you know. There's going to be a movie in the new trilogy coming out every year for the next 3 years. Next year, episode 8 comes out, the year before that, episode 9 comes out. So, movies in between that seem like a little much. I kind of do like having to wait. I'll watch all of them, but it just, in my opinion, does seem like a little much. And if you ask, this is all the Force Awakens stuff I have, unfortunately, right now. I would like to get the 3-inch figures, because I obviously have a prequel 3-inch and an OT 3-inch collection. But I just can't afford it right now. Again, there's the fan mail. If you want to send me any figures, you can. I'm kidding, I'm not. I don't want to ask for anything. That's kind of rude. But thank you, the comic figure blog, for the question. That means a lot. And I will be back. And that is all of the questions I have. And thank you to everyone who answered, asked a question. I'm just going to go through the people who did. We have MG Villain, MP478, Victoria's Cantina, The Walking Dead Figures and More, The Comic Figure Blog, Darcenic619, Manny D, GCCG, the Angry Squad, and Batboy Manny. Another person actually did ask a question, and I can't even say this name. Oh, and also, God O Rhodes. Thank you. Sorry if I butchered that, but another, as I was saying, another person did, but it wasn't Spanish. I don't speak Spanish, so I can't understand that, so sorry I didn't answer your question. And if you could possibly, if you're going to comment on my videos, use English, because I just don't understand Spanish. So, everyone who asked a question, thank you. I'm not sure if I said Batboy Manny. There you are. And I can tell you in the future, probably not anytime soon, obviously, I will be doing another Q&A, probably within the next year, about probably around the same time, maybe. So thank you for everyone. Now, on Saturday, I'm probably going to get ready to do the collection update, and that will be the final video of the 1,000 subscriber special. And I want to thank everyone for subscribing. And so, yeah, so that is the end of this video. I would like to remind you, you can follow me on Twitter. You can like my Facebook page. You also can write to me or send me items. And I will do fan mail videos. And so, yeah, so there's all that. So I want to thank you all so much for watching and supporting my channel. It really means a lot. And until next time, until Saturday, hopefully, I will see you again. Bye.